Then we'll take care of any questions you have about the quiz I gave back.
I wish you just said a value value. Every time it says calculator, it's locked out with value.
Remember, like, when the skier goes down?
Five. No, two. No. Two. Two.
When the skier goes down the slope, under four. Yeah, watch it.
It's getting our answers up here. We need a bunch more, a few more, I guess. Seven and a half pies, and when you talk about seven and a half, that's three spins. Right, we can take out six of these. So this is the same as 1.5 pi, which is down here, which is 0, negative 1. We want the sine, which is y, negative 1 is the correct answer. You guys did great on that. Does anybody have another, or any question about any of the others? We're all good? Okay, good work. Good work. All right, H. What is the length of the minor arc of a circle from point M to point S? Yep, this one's easy. So easy. How do we find arc length?
Radius
times radians. What's our radius?
Six.
What's our radian measure of our angle?
7 pi over 15.
We just multiply them. So let's see. 42 pi over 15 divided by 3. 14 pi over 5. And if we don't, but if we did have a unit, if our radius was 6 inches, then this would be 14 pi over 5 inches. The arc length matches the radius. Okay? Perfect. All right, I, the equation for the graph shown below, find the values of G and H. Okay. What makes this one a little bit tricky is the curve has been shifted to the right pi over 2. And that really isn't our graph, so we're not sure what's going on. But if the first, this piece of it is pi over 6, and this piece of it is 2 pi over 6, then does it make sense that that's 3 pi over 6 or pi over 2? And there's your sine curve. So whatever A is, it's going to be positive. What is it? 0.5. And the period of the curve is pi over 3. So pi over 3 equals 2 pi over B. So it looks like B must be 6. Everybody okay with that? Remember, A can be negative. Amplitude can't be negative, but A, the number A, can be negative. So you really have to pay attention to whether your curve is going in the right direction or the wrong direction when you do that. All right, take a minute, see if you can get a grip on J. Last one on this page. out? What have you figured out? Okay, what did you get for A? What's the maximum value of J?
7.5.
7.5. So the max is going to happen at 7.5. What's the period of J? Oh, who said that? Joe Funk. You're amazing. How did you get 4/3?
80 divided by
60. Yeah. Did you catch that? That the 80 is revolutions per minute, but we're doing the problem in terms of seconds. So that's 80 revolutions in 60 seconds. So our period is 4/3 revolutions per second. So I'm gonna go ahead then, if my period is 4/3, then I can find my V, can't I, since I have to write an equation? So what is that? Did you get 3/2 pi or 3π/2? So this number right here is 3π/2. Do we have a midline? What is that? 3.75. And Bryce, how did you get that?
Half of 7.5.
Minimum to maximum is going to be 7.5. So the midline right there in the middle. Okay. Did we get an amplitude yet? Now, have you thought about whether this is all it says is write an equation. Whether you should be doing sine or cosine?
Negative cosine.
Julia, why? You are correct. Why? It starts at the minimum. Oh my gosh, the pieces are coming together. Thank you. The curve starts when the rope is on the ground. That's the minimum. So she says the only thing that starts at a minimum is a negative cosine. Is there any phase shift since it's starting right there at zero?
No.
No. You don't need all this. There's your equation. Very, very good. Very thoughtful. Oh, that shouldn't be an X. That should be a T. Sorry about that. I did that on the review sheet too. Okay, speaking of which, let me hand that out and let's take a look at that. Negative π/7. So when I write my parentheses here, if the phase shift is literally -π/7, what goes in here?
Plus π/7.
Yep, that's exactly right. So this is where we can have a little confusion. If it asked for C, you would say +π/7. The phase shift is the opposite of that.
Alright, and a midline of 2. And a period of pi over 3. I feel like I just did this. 6. What do you think? Does that look okay to everybody? Alright, let's do the next one then. This is the one I made a mistake on. Where it says 4x, change that to 4 theta. That should, I gotta keep my variables the same. So it should have a theta there. That isn't gonna change how you do the problem, but now it looks like it's supposed to. All right, see if you can sketch that. Does this bother anybody? This is the way your calculator will produce it if you do a regression. But remember, if you want to know the phase shift, you have got to take this 4 out of the parentheses. So if I do that, if I take the 4 out, I'll have theta minus what? Pi over 4. Which tells me that my negative cosine curve is shifted over to pi over 4, over right pi over 4. Now, if it's a negative, then it's going to start at the minimum, right? I've got my minimum at negative 2, is that correct? Everybody all right with that? Okay, now, what cosine curves do is, they cross the midline, and they reach their maximum, then they cross the midline again, and then they end up right back where they started. Would everybody agree that that's what that's going to look like? So what's the only thing left? To label my x-axis, right? What are these quadrant numbers? Well, that's totally dependent on 2 things. First of all, the period. What is the period of this thing? Ooh, you shouldn't be struggling with this. What's the period? What's the period of every sine curve? Every normal sine and cosine has a period of 2 pi. As soon as you put a coefficient on your variable, what does that guy do? Divides it. 2 pi divided by b is your period. So our period is 2 pi over 4, or pi over 2, which totally means my scale is not good. I'm going to go ahead and finish it. So from here to here is 2/4. So what's this label right here? Where am I ending? From here to here is 2/4. I'm ending at 3/4. And then right smack dab in the middle of 1/4 and 3/4 is 2/4. Now what's in the middle of 1/4 and 2/4? This isn't a great mystery, and this isn't even hard math. It's midpoint. What's the average of 1/4 and 2/4? How do you average? You add them together and divide. divided by 2 and multiplying by a half. So what's in the middle of 2 fourths and 3 fourths? And there you go. Here's your sketch. So I started at the minimum,
okay.
Right? Cosines would normally start up here, so it is negative, and it is upside down. Yeah. All right. What's next? Okay. Take a look at this weird picture. It's periodic. What is its period? What did you say? When I counted, I got 8. 8. Is period. Now that means, remember what that means. That means that whatever happens at 1 is going to happen again at 9 and going to happen again at 17 and so on and so on, right? So when they ask us, okay, what's f of 19? Well, just lose some periods in there. So would f of 19 be the same as f of 3? All right, what's f of 3? I said it was negative 3. I'm kind of checking my key as I go here. F of negative 23. So that would be the same as f of negative 7. For example, it's the same as other things too. And what is that? I got negative 2.1 is what I wrote. I can't argue if you put negative 2.2 or something. It's a little bit under 2. And then what about f of negative 4? f of negative 4. I got negative 2. What's f of 4?
0.
Zero. And then f of 0 is negative 2. Everybody okay with that? Good? Okay. On what interval is sine theta increasing and concave down? So visualize your sine curve. And remember that the period is 2 pi. We're just dealing with sine theta. So pi over 2, 3 pi over 2. You have 4 intervals, the 4 quadrants, and one of them is increasing and concave down. Which interval is that?
0
to pi over 2. Very, very good. What's happening here? Between pi over 2 and pi, we are decreasing and concave down. What's happening here? Decreasing and concave up. Increasing and concave up. All right, number 5, writing a sine equation for this picture. Spectator's board. You got it done?
Yeah.
Tell me what you got.
I just want to get the C for the A and then for B, I got 2.
Yeah.
And then there wasn't a phase. There wasn't a phase shift. And then plus 10 for D.
All right. Patrick has. has taken a stab at it. Bryce is nodding. All good with that? There's no phase shift because this is a sine curve, and where do sine curves start? On the midline. So if your side, your curve is starting on the midline, it is a straight sine curve. All right, number six, find the frequency. Haven't done that in a little while. Julia?
1/5.
1/2 pi. Well, frequency is reciprocal of period, right? So let's look at our equation. What's the period? The period is 2 pi divided by b. And what's my b?
2.
It's not factored out, but it doesn't need to be for that, for this purpose. So the period pi, which means the frequency is indeed 1/5. What's the phase shift in number six equation? Phase shift is -π/2. Okay. Seven, I've drawn some kind of chart here, and I've told you that the period of this thing is 6. So what's f of 39? This is kind of like the other one we did. What's f of 39?
Four.
What I wrote down on my answers was that f of 39 is the same as f of 3. And then what about -8? Same as f of 4, so that's 0. You guys are masters of those. Okay, number 8, we practiced this a little while ago. Let's take a few minutes, see if we can get number 8 figured out. Who's got A? Let's see. Jacob Gillick, what'd you get for A?
Root 3/2.
I'm good with that. Emily, what about B?
Root 3/2.
Yep. Other Emily, C?
Root 3.
Perfect. How about D? Quint?
-1/2.
For D? Okay, so this is a pi over 4 angle. So, yeah. So it's this one right here, and that's root 2 over 2, root 2 over 2. So it's got to be root 2 over 2, whether positive or negative, root 2 over 2. Everybody okay with that? All right. Catherine, how about E?
1.
Sine pi?
Or 0. Sorry.
Remember, pi is over here. That's the point negative 1, 0. And the sine is y. So the sine of pi is 0. Okay, how about F? Cosine pi over 2. Isn't that also 0?
Yeah.
Because it's up here. Sine negative 5 pi over 3. Negative 5 pi over 3. Xander, did you get that one?
Yeah, is that root 3 over 2?
Positive root 3 over 2. Are you in agreement? Yeah, because where's negative 5 pi over 3? Isn't that around the bottom 1? Yeah, so positive root 3 over 2. Good. How about H? Cosine negative 5 pi over 6. Julia?
Negative root 3 over 2.
Because that one's down in quadrant 3. So X will be negative down there. Good. Tangent 3 pi over 2. Undefined. Very good. Because 3 pi over 2 is down here. And when you put Y over X, you get undefined. And what about 115 pi over 6? What did you think about that one?
Negative
1/2. Jill Funk's over there nodding his head. I think she's right. Because you have 115/6. So I always just do the division, try to do it correctly. So that's 19/6. Positive? Yeah. How much of 19/6 can be disregarded? 18. So this is really 7/6 pi. And I want the sine of it, right? Yep. So that's this angle. The sine is 1/2, but it's down here in quadrant 3, so it would be negative 1/2. Very good, all of you. Very good. Anybody have a question about that? Okay, how many degrees is 22 pi over 5 radians? Any idea? Well, wait a second. All the way around is how many degrees? And it's also in radians, 2 pi. So every 2 pi is 360. Which means every pi is 180, and I have 22/5 pis. So don't I just have to take 22/5 180s? Yeah. And when I did that, I got 792, but I can't remember if I did it by hand or with a calculator. If it was by hand, it could definitely be wrong. No, 792 is right. 792 degrees. All right, part 10, a little bit more interesting here, because what is part 10 asking us to find? The angles that match up with these ratios. So what goes through your mind when I ask you find theta between 0 and 2 pi? What? Raina? So first thing Raina says is it's a pi over 6 angle, because that's where the sines are 1/2. So one of your answers will be pi over 6, but is there another one? 5 pi over 6, because over here, the sine is also 1/2. Okay, so let's take a minute, figure those out with your partners.
over seven. I know, you get under the board there. So zero pi and two pi.
Yeah.
So we have a couple left. Come on, volunteers, let's get these last two done so we can move on. Or you can do the last one. Emily, thank you. And then we're going to take a vote. See if there's any of them we disagree with. They're probably mostly all right. Could be all right. Let's talk about them. Are there any here that we need? Things we need to talk about. Does anybody see anything, Julia?
The first one, wouldn't it be 3 pi over 4 and 5 pi over 4? Because 7 pi over 4 would cancel out the tangent to make it positive.
Okay, be careful. Be careful. Here's my circle. This one over, so this is pi over 4. What's this one? 3 pi over 4. This one's 5 pi over 4. And this one's 7 pi over 4. But over here, cosine is positive and sine is negative, so the tangent's negative here. Do I want negative? Yeah. Yeah, no, I think that's right. Would everybody agree? That's okay? Anybody see any issues here, Catherine?
Wouldn't that one be 4 pi over 3 because it's negative?
Exactly. Which coordinate is cosine? X, right? Where's 5 pi over 3? Isn't 5 pi over 3 in quadrant 4? And x is positive over there. So pi over 3 is the correct angle. We just need to get it in the right quadrant. So that should be a 4. Okay, easy mistake to make, but that's the kind of thinking you have to go through. And then in order to write that answer up there, I erase my directions. Yeah, those are the directions. Is 2 pi included in that? No. So we want to get rid of that 2 pi. It's not a possible answer in this setup. Are 0 and pi okay? Is that where the tangent is 0? Yeah. 0 over 1. So I think everything else is perfect. Have I made any mistakes? Does anybody want to talk about or argue about any of those? We're good? Why is there only one answer to this one? There's two to all the rest of them. Why is there only one to this one? Because there's only one place where the y is negative 1. So that's it. Okay. Let's get through 11 and then I'll stop. Or maybe 12. We'll see about 12. Let's get through 11 first. So what are we given? We are given a sine and a cosine. So I don't know if it's going to help or not, but I'm going to go ahead and put it on the unit circle. The sine is, cosine's negative, sine's positive. So here I am over here at the point, negative 0.91, comma 0.6. Does that make sense to everybody? So now what happens when we add pi, which is half a revolution? Isn't that point going to pop over here? What's the sine now going to be? Negative 0.3. You're using the exact same concepts as you use with your 1 half and 3 over 2, all that stuff. Only we're using these weird decimals. All right, what happens when you add 2 pi? It stays the same. So what's the cosine? Negative 0.91. Doesn't change. All right, C. What happens when you rotate the opposite direction? So remember, under normal circumstances, here's your, you would rotate this way. Well, what's gonna happen when you rotate the other way? Aren't they both gonna be negative? So the sine is negative 0.3. What about cosine negative theta? Stays the same, so it's negative 0.91. What's tangent theta? Three over negative 0.91. About negative 0.330. And what happens when we add pi for the tangent? Well, what does adding pi do? Bring you down here, right? Is that going to change the tangent? No, because now it's positive over negative, or negative over positive instead of positive over negative. Perfect. All right, let's go ahead and do the coterminal, and then I promise I'll stop. Which are coterminal with 2 pi over 7? You're just picking them out. How do we find coterminal angles? Add or subtract 2 pi. So if you take 2 pi over 7 and add or subtract 2 pi, do you get any of those things? I don't think A works, does it? No, A's out. I think B does, though. Oh, Lord, 79 sevenths. What's going through your mind with 39 sevenths? That would be, if I did the division, is that 5?
This is 4, it's 79.
Oh, it's 79. Yeah. What am I looking at? I don't know. Who knows? 79 sevenths, okay. So that is 11 and 2 sevenths. Now that's, there's my 2 sevenths, but I'm adding 11 pi. Is that going to be coterminal? No, it's in the opposite quadrant, isn't it? So that one's out. Negative 40 sevenths. Two pi over seven minus 3 revolutions. This is 42. That works. Negative 40 sevenths. Would you agree with me on that? Okay. We'll stop there. Your minds are blown. We will review one more time, and then our quiz will be the time after that. So plan your lives accordingly.